Dear students and friends, welcome back to my session on PLC in 21 days. We are on day 8. In today's session, it is a theoretical session only, simulation section only. Tomorrow, with the help of the PLC boards, I will be not only showing the real working of this particular program, also I will show you some more programs also. Physically you can see. Okay, in today's session, we will see a program more on inline comparison, okay, then a ladder program, then we will see the simulation of it, okay. So the more on inline comparison. For that, what I said did was, I used two timer based loop. Again, I am generally using a timer, a two line loop. It's a two line actually, line 1 and line 2. This is T0 loop actually. Then one more timer loop called T1 loop. Okay, I'll explain now. In this loop, I used T1, whose value is 150 into 0.1 second, that is 15 seconds. This loop will run for 15 seconds. So the moment, this is the rising pulse input. Once the X0 input is on momentarily, then this loop M0 is on, M0 is latched, time being you ignore this one, T1 you don't look at now, okay, I will tell you later. So M0 is on, M0 is latched, so M0 is permanently on till T0 reaches K150, that is 15 seconds. So this M0 is on, this M0 is on, so T0 timer starts triggering from K1 to K150. So once it reached K150, T0 triggered. If the T0 is triggered, this will switch off M0 circuit. At the same time, this T0, I put T0 here again for the second loop. This is the second timer loop. This gives signals at two places. Here it stops M0. Here it starts M0 timer T1 loop. So timer T1 loop started. So M1 on, M1 is latched, so M1 is permanent. Again M1 started triggering the T1 timer. The T1 timer will run only for 0.3 second, K3 divided by 10, 0.3 seconds. Once T1 reaches 0.3, it is a normally closed contact. It is triggered. It is on now, instantaneously, momentarily. So this will cut off M1. At the same time, I use T1 here. It is a normally open contact. This is normally closed contact. This is normally open contact. This normally open contact T1 cut M1, but start M0. That means for 15.3 seconds. This 15 plus 0.3, 15.3 seconds, this loop will be continuously running endlessly. This will be running continuously endlessly. It is an infinite loop, I could say. That infinite loop is possible only if I include T1 here. Okay. Now, if this is not there, it will run only once. After that, how to trigger X1 to be initiated, X0 to be initiated, okay. Then how to cut this loop, actually, it is endless, you know. For that only, I used another input X1 as normally NC type, normally closed type. If N1, X0 is on, that will cut the loop, okay. So I think you could understand the two different blocks, timer T0 block, timer T1 block. This T1 again trigger the T0 timer block again, so it becomes infinite. Now X1 input is to cut that infinite loop actually. So this is on the one side, this is over. Other side, you see carefully, I used inline comparison. Here all along I use this greater than and greater than or equal to and less than or equal to symbols actually. So this is one condition, This is another condition. Since both are in series, that is called AND logic. If these two conditions are satisfied, the Y0 bulb output, Y0 will be triggered. Y0 is on. Now you see, the moment X0 is on, then T0 K50, K150, it starts triggering from starting from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 up to 150. Once it reaches 150, this is stopped. This starts for 0.3 seconds. Again, it go back. T1 triggered. T1 started ticking from 1 up to 150. It goes continuously. Now we will see the, it is something like a if condition in C language. Maybe in Arduino also we are, running, you know, the if condition. If, that is if T0 is greater than or equal to K1, of course K1 is the start for T0. All along I used only T0s, not T1. Okay. And T0 is less than or equal to 25. That is between 0.1 to 0.25 seconds, 2.5 seconds, 0.1 to 2.5 seconds, Y0 is on. Again, I repeat, this statement is something like a two if conditions actually. This is one if condition and this is another if condition. These two are satisfied, then only this is on, otherwise it is not off. So after K25, the next value after K25 is K26. So when it moves beyond 25, Y0 is off till 150, till this 150. Till this 150. Okay. If this is understood, all the other lines are self-explanatory. So take for example the Y1, the timer T0 starts clicking from K1 up to K150. So up to K19, this is not true. So once it reaches K20, the T0 timer, then this is true. Then it should be less than or equal to 50. So between 2 seconds to 5 seconds, this is on. Clear? Now the third output. Between 4.5 seconds to 7.5 seconds, this is on. Between 7th second to 10th second, this is on. Between 4th second and 12.5th second, this is on. Between 9th second and 14.9th second, this will be on. You can change any value. Suppose say double click it. If you want, you can put 30. Any value you can change. Any value you can change. Right? So this is the X1 is the reset actually. Okay. So press F4. I think this will be self-explanatory. So now let me show you. Now I'll keep only this line visible. The first one, the initial pages not required, because initial pages not required. These things alone you require. So you will be seeing Y0, 1, Y1, Y2 up to Y5, 6 outputs, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, okay. Now shall we see the, let me save it. Shall we see the ladder logic? Yes. Start ladder logic. Now you see here T0 will be assigned with 0 at the start. It is something like running a serial bulb. Okay, you see T0 is 0 actually. Everything is 0 here. Okay, so no equation. There are six lines actually. Line 1, line 2, line 3, line 4, line 5, line 6. All are not true, as each line has got two if conditions. Inline comparison. Now Alt 1 device test. Let me trigger X0 only once. Then switch off. Now you see, let me close this one also. Now you see, I think you could, you see initially, so now 150, now let us see 0 1 2 3, Y0 is on. After that, after some time Y1 on, after some time Y2 is on, after some time Y3 is on, after some time Y5 is on. But this Y4 will be bit on between K40 to K125. So see the numbers running. It runs between 0 to 150. So it is something like a sequential serial bulb lighting. See the numbers carefully. Okay. Anyway, I'll be giving you the program. If you have a GX developer, somehow you try to get the developer from your own sources. Download, install the GX developer, and this program I'll give you. Okay, as a program file itself now for the first time. You download it and open this file under the GX developer. You can see the simulation. Okay, so you see, so it is an endless loop. It is endless loop. How to cut it? Again, device test. X0 on momentarily. X1 on momentarily. X1 on momentarily. The moment I switch on X1, for a split second, it is sufficient. Everything is off. Everything is off. Program is not running, so it is 0. T0 is 0. Okay. I hope this is sufficient for today's session. As I said earlier, three programs I'm running. The SolidWorks is running good. If you come sequentially right from the lesson one, again, if you are coming in between right from the day one, you please watch all my videos. Then only it is understandable. Similarly for Arduino. This one, I admit myself that I am jumping from one place to other place, but still you are able to cope up with the subject. Okay, some subscribers, they asked me to teach this particular thing from the basics. Again, tomorrow, for the tomorrow session, I will, with the physical board, I'll type small programs, then I'll run it. You'll see it. I'll run this also. Okay, so then you will come to understand, you will have a better understanding, a clear idea about the PLC also. You see, this kind of thing is more flexible, I could say. You can easily control everything. So in a 100 millisecond timer, you can switch on and switch off any outputs. This kind of flexibility is not available in Arduino actually. I see, on one side Arduino is powerful on some aspects. On some aspects PLC is powerful. Okay, but even now the industry is still extensively using PLC actually, right? So if you like my channel, probably would have subscribed it already. If not, you please subscribe my channel. Then inform others, let them learn not only this PLC, also the SolidWorks and Arduino also. See, maybe after some time I'll be integrating three different things actually, either SolidWorks 3D printing or SolidWorks PLC or SolidWorks and Arduino. Okay, so because all these three things should not be decoupled. It should be coupled. Okay, then only we can make some products. Okay, thank you so much.